What is happening, everyone? My name is Phil with Think Make Do, and we are back on the second half of our furniture or floating TV stand video. Now, I've got all the rest of the parts I need to make the front-facing cabinets and the drawer, so I want to show you all the parts that I got. So I got these soft close hinges, and these are a particular kind. I believe they're inset, so that means they sit on the inside of your cavity. Right, and then the three-quarter panel we're going to use is going to be recessed in here, and it's going to lay flat, so flush with the surface of the cabinet. Now, there are many different types of hinges. This is just one of, I think, six of the major styles that you can use, but this is to hide the hinge and not have any actual reveal of the hinges when you're opening and closing. Now, the middle drawer, I finally went and got the right size soft close drawer pulls, and these I believe are 12 inch. Yeah, so these are 12 inch and my cavity is 14 and a half, which means I'll lose about an inch or so of space, but what I'm gonna do is I'll have these installed and then I will make the drawer out of this half inch plywood that I have here, and then the very outside face is going to be three-quarter material, and it's going to sit flush within this cavity as well. I also went and replaced the LED strip that's going to go on the bottom here. This one has a remote, which is what I wanted, so the remote's going to go inside this drawer, and I'll be able to change the color whenever I want to, right? So. Here comes the moment of truth for this first set of door hinges. So you see I routed out about half an inch from this plywood. This is my test piece. And I have these straight. I essentially put them against a straight edge so I knew that both of them were perpendicular. And now I'm gonna place this inside the cavity and I am going to screw. I'm essentially gonna screw these in wherever they go, like right here. And that will set these two pieces. Then I can unscrew, I think, this bolt here and slide this whole platform out, and then transfer these over to my actual final cut piece of lumber or plywood that's gonna be the door itself. About an 1/8 inch gap here. I should be able to sink that in a little more. And then obviously this test piece is a little bit too long. But, ooh. Okay, it looks like I need at least 1/8 inch or 1/16 inch gap all the way around. So when I cut my main piece, I'll make sure that there's 1/16 inch gap all the way around, and that will be my buffer for the entire piece. I am pretty excited because this is my first time I'll ever be putting a hinge together. And if I get it right and it's adjustable and it works, I'll be pretty darn excited. So let's try this out. Oh, Uh-oh. I haven't made a handle yet, so I actually don't know how I'm gonna open this. Stupid. Okay, generally speaking, I'm happy with this. It's a pretty long door, so that's one issue. What I'm going to do is, I think I'll put a little stopper here on this side so it doesn't overextend, but I think that's the way to go. We have both doors on, so now we're gonna work on this drawer. And for that, we need to measure our drawer pulls. Figure out where these are gonna go. Probably on the bottom, because that's honestly the easiest thing to do. Figure out the depth. So I'm gonna use a 3/4 inch piece of plywood as the front cover, and then we're gonna have the box. Well, that was dumb. I think I just lost all the footage of me cutting the wood and like the 100 passes it took to get all this chiseled out. Oh, and this is breaking. But if you look, it fits. That fits decently. Thank you. I may have lost a lot of footage, so I'm sorry about that, but I got my front face in my drawer and pretty much everything settled. And, it might require some sanding, but like it's so close to just being right where it needs to be. So it's a little tight here at the bottom. Nothing too major. I don't have drill pulls yet, so I have to drill a hole in the back and I can push it forward like that to get it out. All right. Let's see what this LED thingy is all about. Nothing? Oh. There we go. Cool. What does all this stuff do? Very cheesy, but probably looks cool at night when this thing is kind of facing down, right? Okay. Next thing I'm gonna do, since this is mostly figured out, I'm gonna drill some holes in the back for wiring, HDMI cables, just so that there's easier cable management. And then I have to pick a stain, or I'm gonna test the stain patch on something like this, see what it will look like when I do the whole dang thing. So let's do that. Okay. I just tested this ebony wood stain, thinking that it'd be a little bit lighter than this, but it's pretty dark, and I think it's too dark, and it will kind of screw with the contrast between the formica and the wood, which I wanted to be more of a dark brown color. And now that I think about it, when I look at this ebony, it's kind of spot on with what it said it was going to be, and I'm just maybe an idiot, because look at that. That's pretty accurate. So I'm gonna have to drop by the hardware store tomorrow and get a lighter stain, and I don't know, maybe I'll use this for something later in the future.
I wanted to take an opportunity to thank everyone here who has been watching and commenting on the videos. I really appreciate the feedback. If you are new to the channel, please consider liking and subscribing, and definitely let me know your thoughts, what you like about this project and the video series, as well as what you'd love to see next. I really want to hear from you and make things that you guys enjoy too, that I like to build. So anyway, enjoy. Pretty much all done here, and what you're seeing now is me at home installing the new cabinet on our wall. And it is a floating shelf, so I am setting up the French cleat, and I also forgot to put a little access hole for a power cable to come in from underneath, so I just did that. Mounted the one side of the French cleat to the wall along the studs with a stud finder, and then I just placed the furniture or the floating stand on top, and it sat really nicely. So the rest of it's just cable management, making everything look pretty. And I think we did a pretty good job. The lighting looks really nice against the grayish tone of the floor, and it kind of comes off of the white wall and gives another glowing effect. It's really nice at night, so I hope you enjoyed it.